This week's highlight: will Brent crude hold above $80? Traders will be watching Europe's appetite for LNG, and cross-border power markets will be in focus. This week, the oil and metals market will be looking at the consequences of recent events in Turkey. The oil market's focus will be on the potential strain on relations between key oil producer Saudi Arabia and its Western allies over the disappearance of Jamal Khashoggi, a journalist critical of the Saudi regime. The Turkish authorities have accused the Saudi governments of murdering Khashoggi at the Saudi consulate in Istanbul. Saudi Arabia has strongly denied the allegations. U.S. President Donald Trump has threatened to punish the Saudi government were it to be found responsible for Khashoggi's death. France, Germany, and the U.K. have called for a credible investigation into the case. But in a statement Sunday via state-run media, Saudi government officials rejected any threats and pointed to its influential and vital role in the global economy. Any tensions between Saudi Arabia, one of the world's largest oil producer, and the West could have far-reaching implications for the energy complex. The metals market will be waiting to see whether the release from house arrest in Turkey of U.S. pastor Alex Brunson will result in an easing of U.S. tariffs on imports of metal from Turkey. The U.S. doubled the tariffs on Turkish imports to 50% for steel and 20% for aluminum in August, citing the Brunson case. Brunson was accused of links to the Gulenist movements, which President Recep Tayyip Erdogan says was behind the attempted coup against him in 2016. Brunson denies the charges. Moving from Turkey but staying with oil, one of the key questions on the minds of markets will be whether benchmark Brent crude futures will hold above $80 a barrel after a sharp reversal at the end of last week. Predictions of $100 oil started to look a little shaky, with key forecasts from the International Energy Agency and OPEC turning bearish. Brent fell back sharply from four-year highs on Thursday and Friday. The IEA cut its estimates of global oil demand this year and the next by 100,000 barrels each day, citing currency depreciations, trade disputes, and a revision to its data on China. Prices will also keep European gas traders watching the rate of LNG send-out into the network to make way for a possible wave of LNG imports incentivized by prices in Europe. A fall in LNG prices in Asia last week almost halved the premium for November S&P Global Platts JKM to the Dutch TTF hub to just $1.50 per MMBTU. Send-out rates at the Gate terminal in the Netherlands have hit a six-month high ahead of several cargoes expected this week. That's represented by the blue line in the chart currently on your screen. Sky-high shipping rates have also made it more lucrative for cargoes to stay in Europe. This week's social media question is, how big a role will LNG play in Europe's energy mix this winter? Tweet us your thoughts with hashtag PlatsMM. Over in the power markets, it's set to be an interesting week as Belgium's energy minister travels to Berlin for talks on winter power supply. Belgium is down to just one out of seven nuclear reactors until mid-November, with the potential for a knock-on effect on neighboring markets. Cross-border capacity will also be a key focus for power trader this week. Monthly capacity auctions start Monday for Germany-Austria, where spreads have widened more than expected since the split of the common bidding zone on October 1st. Turning to petrochemicals, EU statistics agency Eurostat will publish a new set of export-import data on Tuesday. The European polymers market is eagerly awaiting the figures to see whether there was a fresh surge in imports of polyethylene from the US. Polyethylene is used to make plastic bags and packaging. As part of its trade war with the US, China has imposed high duties on imports of US material. As a result, the European market participants have long been bracing themselves for a higher volume of polyethylene from the US entering their market. Thanks for kicking off your Monday with us, and have a great week ahead.